Hey everyone, last July I created video 123 on using ChatGPT to create Flipper Zero applications. JavaScript programming for the Flipper Zero has changed quite a bit since then. In this video, we're going to look at the updated JavaScript, and I have training files for each of the firmwares. AI has improved a lot since my last video, but it still can't create JavaScript for the Flipper Zero without training files. Last time I used ChatGPT, so this time we'll use Grok for our AI agent. Leave a comment below and let me know which AI agent you use to create JavaScript.
Okay, so first we'll load github.com, whack James and Derek, Flipper Zero Tutorials. Click on the green code button, and then click on download zip. Once that's downloaded, we'll go ahead and choose show in folder. Then right click on the zip file and say extract all. We'll go ahead and pick the default folder and say show extracted files when complete. And then inside of Flipper Zero Tutorials main, you should have a JS folder. And then inside of that, you should have an AI folder. Inside of that will be the training files for whichever firmware you're using.
First, we'll drag all of our JavaScript and text file into the AI chat window. These files tell AI how to create JavaScript for the Flipper Zero. Next, we'll ask AI to create a script that prints Hello World. I should have said, can you create a Flipper Zero script that prints Hello World? But I accidentally said, create a Flipper Zero script. Luckily for us, it still understood what I was talking about. For each JavaScript response, you'll click the copy button. Then we'll right click and choose new and then text document. And then we'll name this one hello-1.js and confirm the file name extension. Then right click, open with notepad, and then paste and save the JavaScript. In QFlipper, navigate to the files, SD card, apps, scripts folder, and then you'll drag your JavaScript into the QFlipper window. Now that the AI file is on your Flipper, we'll go into apps and then down to scripts. And then you should see that AI JavaScript file. Go ahead and run it. And there it is, Hello World. This is the process we'll follow for each of our JavaScripts. Congratulations on writing JavaScript for the Flipper Zero. Next, we'll ask it to try to simplify the code. That doesn't involve all this code of like 100 milliseconds and a timer and all kinds of stuff. And you can see from the training files that it understands the Flipper Zero JavaScript restrictions, like using let for variable declarations and whatnot. Okay, that version looks a lot simpler. Let's go ahead and copy that code. And then we'll create a new text file. And this text file, we'll go ahead and call hello-2.js and rename the extension. And then we'll open that file in Notepad, paste our contents, hit save. Back in QFlipper, in our scripts, we'll drag our JS into that scripts. And then in here, we'll go to our hello2.js, and there it is still, hello world. Next, we'll make a more advanced script where we prompt for the user's name, and then we say hello name. And if no name is entered, then we want to still print hello world. I'll go ahead and fix the punctuation, but it typically can figure it out. We'll go ahead and copy that script. I copied that to my Flipper as name1.js. We'll open that script and then we'll type in our name. And then we'll hit the save button and it says, hello, Derek. We'll go ahead and exit the script and we'll rerun the script. And this time for enter your name, we'll leave the prompt empty and we'll just click save. And it says, hello world. So next we'll ask to create a BadUSB script that enters the top 10 most popular 4-digit pins. And then after each pin, it presses enter and waits 5 seconds. So it turns out I forgot to ask for a JavaScript BadUSB, so instead it wrote a Ducky script. The Flipper Zero does have a BadUSB program, and that supports something roughly like Ducky version 1.0. So I'll go ahead and copy this script. And then on our Flipper, we'll go down to BadUSB. And BadUSB is not compatible with QFlipper. I'll unplug my Flipper Zero. I saved that script in ducky.txt and copied it onto my QFlipper. I'll open the BadUSB app and choose my ducky.txt script. And then I'll connect my Flipper Zero back to the computer. And then we'll go ahead and choose to run the script. And we can see that that script typed in our first pin. Now it's waiting 5 seconds. There's our second pin. And then I'll just go ahead and jump ahead to the end of the script. And for more advanced BadUSB scripts, you probably want to give it BadUSB training files. So I'll let it know that that worked great, but I'll ask it to create a JavaScript BadUSB app. So now it's rewriting the script in JavaScript. And that looks like JavaScript. Good. And I highly recommend reading what it outputs so you can learn more about what's actually happening. So it turns out this is a case where I asked for something that wasn't in my training files, so it's not really sure how to create the proper code. So in this case, I'll go ahead and find a BadUSB sample script, and we'll drag that sample script into our chat window. And then we'll ask it to create a script based on that code. In the training files I'll provide, I'll try to include a BadUSB sample script. When you find sample code, I recommend you try it first to make sure it works with your firmware. And this time it's doing that require BadUSB, so it looks like it created a reasonable script. So I've copied the script and saved it as badusb-1.js. Put that on my Flipper, and I've set focus to our text file. And now I'm opening up that JavaScript and we'll give it a run. Okay, there's that first pin, 1, 2, 3, 4. Looks like it did not press enter. And it's been at least 5 seconds and it hasn't tried to do anything else. So when things don't work, just tell the AI what you actually saw, and hopefully it will come up with a new version. In our case, on my screen, it said USB is connected, starting pin attempts, dot, dot, dot. It typed 1, 2, 3, 4, didn't press enter, didn't type any other pins. And then again, we'll go ahead and copy that file. We'll make a new badusb-2.js. We'll copy the contents, we'll copy it to our QFlipper, and then we'll run the JS. This time it's pressed enter after the pin. And 5 seconds later, it's typed in the next pin. So it looks like it's working correctly. And then I'll let it know that the last script worked correctly. And it actually spit out some other suggestions on future improvements. So next we'll try to do some GPIO, and I'll tell it about my diagnostics board for MakeItHackin. And in the early 80s, there was a show called Knight Rider, and so I'll go ahead and reference that for the effect I'm looking for. So it searched 25 web pages. It read the web page on Tendi from MakeItHackin, and it even understands I'm talking about the scanner light on kit. So we'll scroll back up to the top and copy that code. And here we can see that Knight Rider effect. It turns out that SWC, SIO, TX, RX and 1W are not addressable using JavaScript. So that's why those lights are always on or always off. So we'll go ahead and ask it if it's possible to use those pins, which it's not possible in JavaScript, but it is possible if you were using C to control our LEDs. And here it's going to give us two different responses. Go ahead and make the window a little bigger. And when we run the code from the right, we see this error message. We'll go ahead and say we prefer the response on the right. But then we'll let it know that we got an error message. And we'll copy the text from the flipper 0. And you can see that colon 23. That means we were on line 23. And Notepad will use Control G to go to line 23. And we'll copy the contents of line 23 so it knows exactly which error we had. And had we told it that initialize pin PC0 above our error, that would have helped it also reduce down where the error was. I'll put a link to my JavaScript wiki in the description as well as these training files. And when you scroll down on the page, you'll see a set of supported features for JavaScript and a set of not supported features for JavaScript. So when you're asking AI to create a JavaScript for you, make sure that those features are available in your firmware. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, leave a comment below or contact me on Discord.